eating. Go on the other side.
I was gonna say she's below it. Here they are. You're gonna wave?
Hi.
Yes, I know I'm behind, but I'm a member of the garden club too.
Thank you. Thank you. Day is always a special day to honor our fallen American soldiers. And perhaps this one is even a little more special. It's the first Memorial Day after the 100th anniversary of the end of World War I. It's only a few days before the 75th anniversary of D-Day. And it's the 200th anniversary of our special town. I'd like to recognize our speakers this morning, Reverend Mawina, Grand Marshal Rick and John Furlow, Selectmen Kemper and Parker, and Representative Lenny Mira. Now our Veteran Services Agent, Karen Tyler, will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. The Pawtucket Band will now play the national anthem. Lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, today we remember and pay tribute to the men and women of the armed services who have died in the defense of our nation. They paid the ultimate sacrifice for the freedoms we hold so dear. In the words of sacred scripture we hear, there's no greater love than this, than to lay down one's life for a friend. It is only by your grace and the love they have for you and for this nation that gave them the strength to lay down their lives. We beseech you, O God, to receive these servants of peace into your loving presence and grant them the eternal peace that surpasses all understanding. We also remember the families of these great heroes. They too suffer a great and painful sacrifice. Bestow upon them the blessing of your consolation and peace. May you ease their sadness as they continue on the road to serenity and hope. To you we offer this prayer, knowing you fulfill the heart's desires of those who seek you with noble intentions. May our prayer for true and lasting peace be answered in accordance to your will and for the good of your sons and daughters. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, the King of peace. Amen.
I'd like to introduce Sage Seymour to read in Flanders Field by Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae.
Flanders Fields by John McCrae. In Flanders Fields the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high, if you breathe faith with us who died. We shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders Fields.
And now I'd like to introduce Cassandra Brzezinski to read We Shall Keep the Faith by Moina Michael.
We Shall Keep the Faith by Moina Michael. Oh, you who sleeps in Flanders Fields, sleep sweet to rise anew. We caught the torch you threw, and holding high, we keep the faith with all who died. We cherish, too, the poppy red that grows on fields where valor led. It seems to signal to the skies that blood of heroes never dies, but lends a luster to the red of the flower that blooms above the dead in Flanders Fields. And now the torch and poppy red we wear in honor of our dead. Fear not that ye have died for naught. We'll teach the lesson that ye wrought in Flanders Fields.
At this time, it's been my honor that I'm going to introduce our Grand Marshals for today. We have two of them, one being Rick Thurlow, and one being John Thurlow. We are honored that Rick and John are serving as our Grand Marshals for today's parade in the remembrance of this Memorial Day. The Thurlow family has been in West Newbury since the 1700s, and in fact, one of his family homes has been in their family continuously for all of these centuries. The oldest burial at the Walnut Cemetery, dating to 1726, was a direct relative of to the Thurlows, and the family may also pay respects to many generations of ancestors at the Rural Cemetery. Rick Thurlow is a fifth generation nurseryman, if you didn't know that. Not many people, everybody knows that. And part owner of the family's Cherry Hill Nursery, which dates back to 1832. He was the first graduating class from the Pawtucket High School, one of 13 boys and 39 girls in the class of 1959. And for 4 years, he attended the University of New Hampshire. Rick served in the U.S. Army for 2 years and stationed at Fort Huachuca in Arizona. Thank you, Rick. I knew I had to mess that one up. In addition to his work at the nursery, Rick worked doing farming throughout New England, from Bristol, Rhode Island, to Concord, New Hampshire. A civic-minded person, Rick has served West Newbury for over 40 years, including his role at various times on the Planning Board, Library Board of Trustees, Board of Appeals, Historical Commission, Water Commission. And he has also worked as the grave digger for 50 years. Thank you for that. And has plowed snow in West Newbury for 49. In addition to his local service, Rick has served the USDA Farm Bureau for over 40 years. John Thurlow is also a fifth generation nurseryman, a graduate of Newburyport High School and the University of Massachusetts. John served in the U.S. Army for 2 years as a medic stationed in France, and as well as serving 6 years in the Army Reserve. He has served the town as a member of the Conservation Commission and Historical Commission, and along with his brother, has a lifelong connection to the town with the beloved Cherry Hill Nursery. And while we have honored both their role as Grand Marshals, it is also our intent to honor these men, and by honoring John and Richard, we are also honoring the prior generations of the Thurlow family and all that they have contributed to the town of West Newbury and to our nation. Thank you. You have been a fabric of West Newbury for all these years, and it's honored that you are our marshal for this year's Memorial Day Parade. Thank you.
Glenn pretty much covered everything. Those of you that know me, you don't want to press my hot button and get me talking about town history. I had a good teacher in that I bought my first backhoe in 1969 and started digging graves with Dick Cunningham from Newbury. And I would make the mistake of saying, "Dick, now who are we putting in today?" And he knew the history, going back two or three generations, of everybody that we put in the ground. It kind of sparks your interest into your local history. And one of the more important things is to know the genealogy. And also, it helps if you know the family feuds that go on. And when you start working in the cemetery, if you make a mistake, you're in big trouble. It's been an honor to be chosen as Grand Marshal. And as Glenn said, you're not honoring John and I, you're honoring my other brother that served in the Air Force, and some uncles that have, Uncle Winthrop Thurlow that was in World War I. I would have gone to Vietnam if I'd been in the first half of the alphabet, and knowing some of the people that did go to Vietnam, came back in a body bag, and this is what we have remembered today.
Representative Muir will now give us a few words.
Thank you all for coming out today. And thank you for everyone who put this parade together. It's always a wonderful event, and this year, especially being a bicentennial year, made it extra special. And I think we can all take a little bit of pride that we live in a state and a country that honors its fallen heroes in such an honorable way. Today is the day we put aside to remember those fallen heroes and to hope and pray that someday, no heroes will ever have to die for us again. It's a day of thanks for their valor, a day to remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice. So as we take time to think of those brave men and women, I just want to read some famous words from the Gettysburg Address that we hear highly resolved that each dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth. That's what we're here for today, to remember and honor those who gave what President Lincoln called last full measure of devotion in the fight for our liberty. But Lincoln went on to remind us that it is also the families of these heroes that we're here to honor and remember. As he said about 150 years ago, our nation has a sacred obligation to, as he put it, care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan. Those words, in fact, are inscribed above the entrance of the Department of Veterans Affairs in our nation's capital, and they are spoken at every Memorial Day and Veterans Day. And so we must keep all of our promises to the men and women who have served. When they swore an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, they made a commitment to all of us. And at the same time, we as a nation incurred a sacred obligation to them upon their return home to heal their wounds, build their lives, to care for their survivors. Finally, let us also take a little bit of pride in the words of President John F. Kennedy. Let every well or ill, that we shall pay any price, bear any burden, support any friend, or oppose any foe, to assure the survival and success of liberty. And so to the families of our fallen heroes, and to the heroes still fighting, I want to say thank you for your service and your sacrifices. A grateful nation honors and remembers you today. Thank you.
Thank you, Lenny. I'm going to read a proclamation from the Governor of the Commonwealth. Whereas, while the nation was still recovering from the horrors of the Civil War, people in cities and towns and across the country gathered to honor those Union and Confederate soldiers who had given their lives celebrating the first Decoration Day. And whereas, after World War I, the nation came together to honor those who had fallen in the service of their country, renamed Memorial Day, the last Monday in May, is when people remember and honor the memory of all men and women who fought and died in all American wars and conflicts. And whereas throughout our country's history, thousands of Massachusetts citizens have fought in wars and conflicts to defend our safety and way of life. And whereas their legacy of patriotism and dedication to country is an inspiration to all Americans, and whereas that all Massachusetts citizens remember the bravery of those who gave their lives so that their sacrifices serve as a reminder of the cost of our freedom. Now, therefore, I, Charles D. Baker, Governor of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, do hereby proclaim May 27th, 2019 to be Memorial Day, and urge all the citizens of the Commonwealth to take cognizance of this event and participate fittingly in its observance. Given at the Executive Chamber in Boston this first day of May, the year 2019 of the Independence of the United States of America, 242nd, by His Excellency Charles D. Baker. God save the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Now the Pentucket Band will play Patriotic Dreams. Thank you.
This is the time in the program where we will read a list of names of West Newbury people who have deceased in the previous year. That would be from Memorial Day to Memorial Day. We do this to honor their names, not so they're not forgotten. It'll be followed by taps. James Trupino, David Fairbanks Jr., Barbara
Gagne. Hartley Welch. Lula Eva LeBlanc. Helen Kelso. Clara Patricia Crew. Joan Helen Gardner. Francis Culver Jr. Gerald F. Pascuma, veteran, World War II. Lorna Lee Kimball. Francis Xavier Babineau, veteran, World War II. David Willis Sherborne, veteran, Korea. Jean Robbins. William George Elvin, veteran, World War II. David George Wallach. Josephine Seforza. Lillian B. Bronis. Pamela Lewis Gilman. Phyllis W. Hobson. Mary Ann Tropino. Anna Elizabeth Cronin. Andre W. Buckley. Thomas Gerald Quinn. Charlotte Mosley Lloyd. Paul A. Bates. Robert Allen Bernard.
Bow our heads in prayer. And now, Heavenly Father, in union with people of goodwill of every nation, embolden us to answer the call to work for peace and justice, and thus seek an end to violence and conflict around the globe. Bless the families of our fallen troops, and fill their homes and their lives with your strength and peace. Bless the leaders of our town, that they may lead with wisdom and justice. Bless its residents, that we may live our lives in quietness, peace, and good health. Bless us, O God, our Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Amen.
thank you all for coming, especially thank the veterans who have attended today. A lot of people put time and effort to make this day possible. I'd especially like to thank Angus Jennings and Teresa Poor for putting together the parade and this. I'd like to thank some other people also. I'd like to thank the band for, thank you very much, and its director, Brian Bennett, thank you very much. The DPW, the police, the fire, emergency management. I'd like to thank Karen Tyler, the veterans agent, thank her. John McGrath and all the participants in the parade. It was wonderful that we had some floats this year. Very happy with the parade. It was, and we had a wonderful day. Thank you. Just a couple of announcements. Youngsters and young at heart people that want to ride in the fire trucks, they will be over there, ride over to the public safety complex. You can visit the memorials on the training field. There's an open house and a cookout at the public safety complex, and also open house on the for the West Newbury Youth League on the Bachelor Field. So